This week, on the Feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary, EWTN celebrated the 41st anniversary of its on-air launch. As we commemorated this special day, others did too. The Republican National Committee released a statement saying, quote, "The Republican Party joins Catholics across America in celebrating the Feast of the Assumption. On this solemnity, Catholics can know that Republicans will always stand for the sanctity of life and to preserve our nation's long tradition of religious liberty and an American's right to live out his or her faith." And shifting gears to some state news, a woman in Nebraska is being charged with aiding and abetting an abortion, violating the state's 20-week ban on abortion. The 41-year-old gave dangerous chemical abortion pills to her teenage daughter, who was about 24 weeks along. After the baby was killed, it's been reported that she went as far as burning and then burying the baby's body. Nebraska authorities were able to obtain information about the case via Facebook messages between the mother and daughter. Joining me now for insight is Chelsea Youman, National Legislative Advisor at Human Coalition Action. Chelsea, thanks for joining me. Could you explain what you know about this case out of Nebraska?
Yes, well, thank you for having me. It's really a sober and frankly a horrific situation that did happen out of Nebraska. A 17-year-old girl, so a minor girl, and allegedly a 22-year-old man who impregnated her, ended up having an abortion through the chemical abortion pill at 28 weeks of pregnancy. If you do not know, that is the third trimester. Her mother allegedly obtained the pills. We're not sure how, but definitely illegally. This was all before Roe was overturned. So last year, she's now 18 years old. And then she went through the process, probably a very traumatic process of full labor because of the chemical abortion pills and delivering a dead child in her bathroom. And at that point, you know, the police reports indicate that they put the child in a bag, burned the remains of the human child, and then he helped assist burying in that child, allegedly. So we have what is frankly, I think, one of the most difficult and sad really a terrible situation all the way around, both for this minor girl who was put in this position, and of course for her dead unborn child. It's really a difficult and sad situation.
Right. I'm getting chills just hearing you explain it. And pro-abortion extremists, on the other hand, are calling this an invasion of privacy because this woman is facing charges after authorities obtained her Facebook messages. What's your response to that?
Yeah, so I think it's really important to know the facts and to clarify that actually all 50 states, no matter what state she would have resided in, would protect her from being charged for this abortion, even in the third trimester. So she's actually being protected from being charged for an abortion. However, one of the many laws in our society protecting victims of homicide, you, me, our neighbors, our friends, are from allowing human remains to be disposed of or burned or buried in someone's backyard. There are all laws preventing that. How we treat human bodies matters in our society. And one of the big reasons is it helped, you know, this man who was 22 years old cover up his crimes, cover up his statutory rape crimes against her by burying this child. And so we have laws in society meant to protect people and victims from scenarios like this. And it's really horrific that this happened, but we do live in a civilized society and one that really should do better by women and unborn children than this.
Yeah, thanks for your insight on that. We'll continue to track that case. In other news, Chelsea, pro-life advocates in Kansas have somewhat surprisingly called for a recount of the Value Them Both amendment votes, a measure that failed by significant margins. Right now, the state is expected to hold a partial vote recount. In a statement after the vote, you said the amendment was not, quote, crystal clear or easily explainable. Do you think that's why the amendment failed?
I think there are a few reasons that it failed. We know that exorbitant amounts of money on both sides of the aisle were poured into this. There was a high turnout in Kansas. And I think that the other side did a really good job maybe ostracizing pro-lifers or making, you know, our views seem extreme when we know that their side is advocating for what we just talked about, third trimester, late term abortions up until birth, and really in several states now, even infanticide after birth. And so our side has work to do. We need to continue to just show their hand at how extreme they are, how pro-death they are. But also, I think we could refocus here in Kansas. I love the passion in that state for life. The fact that they're calling for a recall shows that passion and dedication. But I think that we could channel that passion and dedication towards eliminating the distribution of the abortion pill, doing things like holding those who aid and abet abortions illegally accountable, the physicians and the pharmacies, holding them accountable for wrongful death. There's lots of legislative measures that at Human Coalition Action we've been working on. We have them drafted. Many of them are on our website at hucoaction.org. And we have a lot of work to do as a movement, including work to serve mothers in need and their unborn children through tangible help and resources.
Well, we encourage all of our viewers to check out your website. Chelsea Youman, thanks for joining us from Human Coalition. God bless you.
Thanks for having me. We'll talk to you later.
Yeah, thanks.